Welcome, trail mates, to Soul Journey Snapshots, where we highlight trekkers from around the world who are traveling together through this transformative book, The Soul Primer. I'm Kim Selby, and I'm the host of the podcast Ignite Your Spark. I found the fabulous Kate Schultz, author of The Soul Primer, while she was being interviewed with Deepak Chopra. I just knew I had to meet her and had to interview her on my podcast. And because I loved this book and got so much from it, well, here I am helping her share other trekkers' journeys. Remember, regardless of where we each call home, we are all on this journey together. So I invite you to set down your backpack just for a moment and gather around the virtual campfire with me to welcome fellow journeyer, Tim Niemier. Now, Tim is joining us today from Bellingham, Washington, and I love a quote of his. He really loves turning dreams into reality. And fun fact, he is the author of what seems to be a fascinating book, which I have to read, called The Millionaire Beach Bum. Welcome, Tim.
I'm glad to be here.
Thank you so much.
This is really exciting.
It really is. So we just want to have a little snapshot of your journey with Soul Primer. Tell us about any aha moments that you had while traveling through the Soul Primer.
Well, I'll set the stage a little bit because about a year ago now, I was trying to decide whether to really go for it with a big project, which turns out to be the biggest project of my life. And I somehow deep down, I knew it was going to be big, but I wasn't quite sure about whether to go for it or not. Let me just back up just a little bit. I'll give you a little bit of background. In 97, I sold this company, Ocean Kayak, and that was the first sit-on-top kayak company. And we really did introduce the sit-on-top to the world. And it was a real easy concept because you didn't have to sit inside of this thing. And it really got people a lot more people on the water, which made me feel really well because they felt really liberated on the water. And so it was a great experience like that. And I'd have people coming up telling me that my kayaks changed their life because the kayak, I say it's a prosthetic device for the aquatically challenged. But the experience of being on the water is like this guy I just paddled with yesterday. He says that's his religion. This is his religious experience because he's such a small speck in such a big, we were just on a lake, but it's this big lake. And you feel so incredibly small that, you know, that's spirituality in a lot of people's mind, including my own. So I was about to start, I sold the company in 97 and I was going to start another one. And just before this, I had broken my neck and I felt very vulnerable because I'd almost died. And actually after I fell, I thought, oh, I'm going to be paralyzed because I couldn't feel any of my anything. So I thought, but I was very relaxed. I said, I'm just going to be paralyzed and I'm okay with that. And then the tingling came back and then I got feeling back and I was, but it took me about 9 months, after that, that I did this. I was still feeling a little bit vulnerable because, but there was something where I said, well, I could either be dead, paralyzed, or just go for it. And maybe I just chose the go for it part. Well, even then, I was just deciding whether to go for it. And I was having reservations about doing that. But I thought, if you broke your neck, you can do anything after that. And I recovered and I didn't need, I was very, very lucky that I didn't need surgery and I made 100% recovery. I can move it around and I feel stronger now than ever. So I read this book, Soul Primer, because I had met Kate and she was an instrumental part in getting this next venture off, which is called Origami Paddler. And this makes it even easier than a sit on top to get on the water. because it's a kayak and a paddleboard that folds like that. Let's see if I have the, no, I don't have the.
Well, we'll give everybody the link to your website when we finish. Yeah. I actually saw it and it looks fascinating because I love kayaking and paddleboarding. So you were reading Kate's book and you had this idea, and how did Kate's book help you manifest this idea?
Well, she was the spark that made it happen. I guess when I was reading D for Divinity, I read this little poem: "I am beautiful, divine, with immense power. I'm a spirit on a journey that cannot be contained." And that, God, it gets me goosebumps just thinking about it. That is the thing I realized: I can't contain this, so it has to come out. And I'm just getting emotional thinking about here. I am whole and healed from the traumas and wounds of this life. My powers are being called, and I can no longer play small. Mm-hmm. So I decided I am no longer going to play small, and did this Kickstarter. And like I said, Kate was an instrumental part of this. It wouldn't have happened, and she played a role in this whole thing. That I'm going to write another book about origami, but it went nuts. We did a Kickstarter. The first day we had $230,000 of sales. We raised $3.8 million in 5 weeks. It was nuts. And I found out later, if I would have known this, I don't think I would have done this, but there's only 500 companies out of 87,000 that have raised over $1 million. We were in the top 30 of the all-time Kickstarter events.
Wow. And that is impressive, Tim.
Well, and it was all to new people. And 75% of our supporters, I should say, are women. And the problem that they had, and other people have, they don't realize it, is that they didn't like to put the kayak up on top of the car. They like to put it in the trunk. So we have, take it out of the trunk, put it on wheels, roll it down. And a little thing like that makes a big, big difference. So our supporters have been really, really great. And we've actually videoed Kate, because she really supports this our whole thing. And it's just been fun getting excited together. And there's so many other things that I've done. I did one chapter a week. And that gave me time to really reflect on it for a whole week. I think that's what she recommended. So I got through the whole book. And now what I'm doing is that she has it going again, and I get the emails. So I get to relive that, which is really, really fun.
And it'll be so much fun to see how you get inspired next.
Yeah, exactly. Well, this is just the origami paddler is just the first step. I have plans to make things 10 times bigger. There's other things that have manifested. There's somebody that's recycling plastic from the ocean. And now we're going to try to put that into the boats that we make. And it isn't that simple. Otherwise we would do it, but nothing's simple. So, no. But that just happened just last week.
You know, it's amazing when you take one foot and put it in front of the other, what happens. And that's what I love about the Soul Primer. We take one letter and put it, next and next and next, and work through it at our own time. And we're able to unleash miracles. You were able to unleash because of the letter D, Divinity, and that fabulous poem. And I certainly applaud you. And I know Kate is so very proud of you for what you have accomplished. It's amazing.
Well, Kate was the catalyst.
Yeah.
I think that I'm sort of the resin and she was the catalyst, but without the catalyst, the resin just sits there. So
perfect. Perfect. Yeah. Well, Tim, we're going to wrap up our snapshot today, but thank you so much for sharing part of your transformational journey with us. And where can other trekkers find you? Because we're all on this journey and we want to support each other. What's your website for your origami fold up kayak?
It's simply Origami Paddler. And we didn't say kayak or paddleboard because it's both. It's a paddleboard and a kayak. So it's origamipaddler.com.
Oh, I can't wait. I can't wait
to see. Facebook, we have Origami Family. I think that was the Origami Paddler Family is the Facebook. And that's how we contacted everybody. It's a new way of reaching people.
It is social media for the win, right?
Yeah. All right. I'm honored to be with you today. So thank you so much.
Oh, thank you, Tim. And I just want to say, as we raise our energy together for the global good, it's great to hear from all of our fellow travelers and be inspired by their experiences. Thank you so much. So until next time, keep on climbing and don't forget to enjoy the view, whether you're on the lake or in the mountains, and know that you're always welcome at the Soul Primer Campfire, where we share our stories, our struggles, and our songs. So see you next time.